Polyto. I'm Scott Ketchum, a technical advisor and researcher at Oklahoma State University and a proud citizen of Choctaw Nation. I'm a cultural anthropologist whose research focuses on the vulnerability and resilience of culture in the age of human-induced climate change. In this video, I'll be discussing Indigenous peoples and climate change. Indigenous people are defined by relationships to landscapes critical in the maintenance of their cultural ways. It is estimated that some 370 million Indigenous people live across the planet. There is no universal definition for Indigenous peoples, but as a group, they share many commonalities. One commonality Indigenous people share is an interdependent relationship between the landscapes they occupy and their cultural materials. One example of local ecosystems influencing the development of cultural materials can be seen in the production of capucha, or stickball sticks. Stickball is a game played by Native American communities indigenous to the southeastern part of the United States. The abundance of bottomland hardwood trees like shagbark hickory located in the southeastern provided the materials that made the game possible. Indigenous people have inherent rights to their ancient homelands that are integral to their cultural distinctiveness. Indigenous people are specific populations vulnerable to marginalization and policy in this age of climate uncertainty. We have seen that climate change magnifies existing social stresses facing indigenous communities. It's important to note that the indigenous peoples of North America are not marginal people. However, their interests are vulnerable to being marginalized through geopolitics in the policy decisions of outsiders. National governments have a history of excluding the voices of indigenous peoples in the formation of policies concerning their natural environments. The United States is seldomly described as a system with three major sovereign entities: the federal government, tribes, and states. Currently, 566 tribal governments are recognized as sovereign by the federal government. The process for recognizing tribal sovereignty isn't perfect, and not all tribal communities are recognized by the federal government, but many enjoy recognition in the states that they reside. Indigenous peoples face uncertainty in their ecosystems that sustain their cultural ways as the landscapes change. Native peoples of the world depend heavily on the natural resources and landscapes within the spaces that they call home. These environments define them through intimate relationships within the natural world that structure their culture. These relationships are the basis for a very rich intellectual heritage derived from local observations, referenced in academic literature as a community's traditional ecological knowledge. Traditional ecological knowledge systems consist of very localized data collected for the purpose and application of a very specific community. Community elders use oral stories as one method to transfer this information to future generations. Choctaw elders tell the story of a man sitting on the banks of a river watching a turtle snapping hickory branches. The man honored this moment by bending a hickory branch in the form of a shell, in essence making the very first capucha, or stickball stick. According to this story, a relationship to those local forests was sealed in those hickory branches as a covenant to remember a deeper sense of reverence for one's surroundings. A recent example of how these local observations can inform climate science comes from the observations made by the Inuit during the filming of a documentary on their experiences with climate change. A 2010 article by Guy Dixon in the Globe and Mail recounts a backlash from the scientific community when co-director Emmeru shared the Inuit's belief that the Earth had tilted in a very different direction on its axis. Fast forward to an article published on April 8, 2016 by scientificamerican.com that highlights two separate studies with theories that the Earth's tilt has changed as a result of climate change. The 2014 National Climate Assessment includes a valuable chapter that outlines the main stressors on indigenous peoples as a result of climate change. For example, ecological changes are projected to increase food insecurity due to reduced access to and availability of native plants, as well as increased losses from fires in forests, rangelands, and grasslands. Changes in water quality and quantity will reduce water security for tribes. Landscapes changes stemming from Arctic sea ice loss, the thaw of permafrost, or sea level rise will result in the potential relocation of indigenous communities from their ancient homelands. Despite these challenges, indigenous people offer many examples of resiliency in their communities and in their cultures. The relocation of Native Americans to Oklahoma, despite many hardships along the way, exemplifies this resilience and adaptability. Today, indigenous communities, tribal members, academics, professionals, and activists are working side by side to discuss climate change. Networks and workshops, such as the Indigenous Peoples Climate Change Working Group or Rising Voices, are examples of collaborative efforts that bring climate scientists together with indigenous community members. resiliency to climate change will depend upon whether or not we are willing to listen to and include those whose livelihoods depend upon local ecosystems. Local observations and local responses are two of the many positive benefits to collaborating with Indigenous stakeholders and Native scientists as we plan for and managing a changing climate.